Did you ever have problems with anyone out here because you called Kendrick a weirdo on Twitter back in the day?
No, never.
Really?
And I, it was on. A, it wasn't on. Was it on Twitter? It was on a record.
Oh, it was a record.
And I only did that because, well, one, he was on some weirdo shit. You know what I'm saying? Different from, like, it was different from, you know, the shit I grew up on.
Right.
Fucking Clips, 50 Cent, fucking Gucci Mane,
Jay-Z,
whatever.
It also might have
something
to do with the fact that weirdo is a big word out here.
I didn't know that.
Weirdo is like a very, very disrespectful thing out here, way more than it is on the East Coast.
Well, I did that because there's no rules to a reaction. He made the Control freestyle.
Right.
And that's why I did it. People act like I did it before that. I did it like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's me coming out and I've been representing. I probably made the most records about New York and Brooklyn than any other artist. Even when it's time to make a single and it's not popular to do that because you want to appeal to a broad mass of people. I'm just, nah, fuck that. I'm on New York. I spent my first video repping with my heart. It's about New York. I'm from New York City where it ain't shit pretty except the girls and they most ain't right. And I spent $30,000 on that video to get that shit on BET everything. And I'm always repping New York. So if he says something about New York, I'm offended. And why is it that everybody who, these motherfuckers made full songs dissing him, full replies, and my one little bar is bigger than the songs that they made.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, fucking Mos Def would be considered a widow rap, but he's dope. Backpack. You know what I mean? Maybe right. Not widow, but, like, it's different. I wasn't saying nothing that's a lie. I wasn't making shit up.
Right.
I didn't, like I said, I don't even lie against somebody I'm going against. I didn't say, yo, you suck dick or whatever. I don't know if you suck dick.
It's crazy because so much beef in rap music basically comes down to who's the most liked. Like, because in the shit with you and Joey Badass, it really didn't matter who was right, you know? It mattered that at that time, he was really looked upon as somebody that the industry and the fans were really fucking with, and you had already kind of started to get a reputation for being kind of an asshole, so it really didn't matter that much.
I'm from New York. I'm really,
him
like,
too,
on
right?
Some New York shit, but I'm really, like, different. You got, it's two sides of you. Like, right. Somebody could come in and see a fucking gangbanger or they could see a skateboarder.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all both from LA, but it's two different shit. And now just because that other person got different type of fans, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't nothing with Joey Badass. He's whatever. I'm not carrying on no beef or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying that, like, if you see the fans or the people that it was probably industry people or it was more so fucking, like, little white kids with a fucking gremlin emoji saying, hey, you nigger, and shit like that. Like, these are his fans.
Those
but
kids,
it's a lot of them because they want to internet.
Definitely were fucking with him more than you at that.
That's what
the white, I don't know about the N-word part. The white kids with the gremlin avatar were definitely Joey
But
Badass
that's what
fans.
I'm saying. So just because it's fucking, it's 10 lions, it's 10 sheep and one lion.
Right.
They're just more boisterous. There's a bunch of them because they on the internet. I'm not even on the fucking internet.
Right.
I'm doing a tweet. I'm doing some shit to make money on it. I'm not like an internet person.
Right.
So that's why it might seem, just because you yelling more and you more louder, that don't mean that you tougher. That don't mean that you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But whatever, that shit is in the past, man.
Nah, I feel you for sure.
God is great and the paper straight, man. I'm just like.
So people have done a lot of work to try to smear you with the snitch thing over the last couple of years.
That's a fact.
How do you feel about that? How do you deal with it? For a while, it felt like you were kind of leaning into it, like with the 6ix9ine thing and shit.
I was kind of like. Well, you know what? When 6ix9ine got when was like, I was like, all right, now at least people can see the difference of this is an actual snitch. He was down with a gang. Not, I mean, I don't give a fuck. It's no
right.
It's not nothing with 6ix9ine or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like,
he can't deny being a snitch.
But like, you in the actual gang, you join a gang. You can't tell on the gang, no matter what. Those are your friends. Like, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't like you. You took that oath. You into that shit.
Mm.
It's not no internet shit that's already out in the public. Gang shit is in the streets. So, like, I really just stopped. As long as it's not said, like, to me here, again, it's the majority of the gremlin avatars and shit. You feel me?
Right.
Like, I'll be out with my fucking kids front row of fights. It'd be, yo, Choya, yo, all kind of shit, right? Chef, you be with me? We go to fights with it. It just be nothing but pictures and it, like, it never, yo, I had my security. He said, damn, this job is fucking easy. That's a fact. So I don't really, like, the internet didn't make me. I came from selling my music in the streets. That's why my foundation is so strong. That's why if blogs don't post me, my shit is gonna still go. I'ma still be profitable. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta just control what you could control. And the rest you can't give a fuck about, because like I was calling my pastor about some other shit, like, yo, I want to do something, but yo, like, am I going to block my blessings? If that shit was happening and I was fucked up and I was broke and you see Troy Avin, I'm just like a pop broke ass nothing, then you know it is wartime, because you motherfuckers made me broke. But all this shit is happening and it just keep on leveling me up. Mm. Maybe it's not leveling me up fast, but it's still leveled up more than I would have ever been leveled up if I'd have just stayed in the streets.
Right.
So like you gotta take it. If somebody was to tell me, yo, Choya, if you was gonna go through all of this, you gotta go through all of this bullshit, but you gonna have this much, I'll take it any day. Oh, but give me that.
It's a weird situation for you too, because you can't, I'm sure you would love to just come out and tell your whole side of the story in terms of certain things, yeah, but you know that you putting out more detail out there into the world is probably a bad thing for you overall.
Yeah, that's a fact, especially when you got an open court case, and then you can't, like, you don't want to prove to fake people how real you are.
Well, anything you say contradictory or anything that, like,
oh, the truth never changes.
You accidentally say the wrong word in telling the story. Yep. I'm sure your lawyers told you.
But the truth will never change. That's one thing about the truth. The truth will never change.
Right.
And I'm being a lion and a bunch of bullshit. All
right, guys. So the No Jumper Clips channel right here. Make sure you subscribe. We just blasted past 30,000 subscribers. Our next goal is 50,000 subscribers. Please help us out and hit that red button. Thank you.